You can also infer as much from her note. She specifically tells the reader to check the nameplate. She would only have written that if she knew the nameplates had been switched.
But why would she switch them in the first place?
She wanted someone to come to the room she was in, and also hide the fact that it was Makoto's room.
What?
Inviting someone to your room, but not telling them you'd switched rooms. Why would anyone do that?
To understand that, we first need to understand what happened after she invited the person into the room. That's where the answer lies.
What happened then was probably whoever she invited over came in and attacked her!
We figured it out! We know who did it! Whoever she invited over is the culprit!
But we still don't know who it is, you goddamn idiot!
Sayaka fought with her killer there in the room, yes? Perhaps the answer to our previous question lies in that initial struggle.
Yes, I think you're right.
Then we just have to figure out what happened during the fight, right?
That reminds me. There was a replica sword at the murder scene. Was that perhaps used during the fight?
Oh yeah. What's the deal with that sword?
Sayaka suggested I should hold on to it. I thought it might come in handy if I had to defend myself. It seems pretty likely that the killer used it to break Sayaka's right wrist.
How the hell could you possibly know that's what broke her wrist?
All you have to do is take a good look at her broken wrist, and it should become pretty clear. Right there where her wrist is all swollen, there's something glittery there. See?
Is that gold?
It sure is. Specifically, the gold coating from the replica sword. You barely have to touch that stuff, and it'll stick right to you. And there's some on her wrist because...
I got it! Because she got hit with the sword! Right there on her wrist!
I see. And so the truth draws ever closer.
Alright, then it's about time to solve this mystery. When the fighting broke out, the culprit grabbed the sword, and that's when the first blow was dealt. The sword-based sneak attack!
No, it's wrong! Actually, no. I don't think the fight started with the sword.
Why not?
Because the sword sheath had been scratched. See? There's a gash in it. Like someone cut into it with something sharp.
Something sharp? You mean like the kitchen knife? That was the only sharp thing found at the scene.
Stop jumping ahead! Slow down and explain it so I get what the hell's going on.
If the sword was used first, there wouldn't be any explanation for the scratch on the sheath. If you are going to attack with the sword, You take it out of the sheath first, right?
That's true. With the sheath on, it'd be heavy and bulky and useless as shit.
Okay, so how did the sheath get damaged?
If they got attacked with the kitchen knife, maybe they grabbed the sword as a defensive impulse. In that situation, there wouldn't be any time to actually unsheath the sword.
So you're saying the sword was initially used to defend against an attack from the knife? Which means whoever had the kitchen knife was the one who attacked first!
I think I get it! So here's how it all played out. The culprit came in, found the kitchen knife hidden there somewhere. Then they took the knife and attacked Sayaka before she knew what was happening. So she grabbed the sword to defend herself, but then the culprit took that from her too. Then, after they broke her wrist with the sword, they took the knife and finished it.
Sorry, but I don't think Sayaka used the sword to defend herself.
What? How the hell can you not think that?
Because she never held the sword at all. There's a certain part of her body that makes this clear.
I got it! You're talking about her palms, right? The palms of her hands were perfectly clean, so I don't think she ever picked up the sword.
That just by looking at her palms.
Like I said before, the gold coating on that sword comes right off. All you have to do is touch it. In fact, if you look, you'll notice that a lot of the gold has already come off the handle. It's safe to assume that's because whoever used the sword got some of it on their hands. There's really no way she could have picked it up and come away completely clean.
Maybe she washed her hands after she escaped into the bathroom.
Sorry, but I don't think so.
Why do you say that? Is it because you think I'm ugly?
No, that's not it at all. According to the Monokuma files, Sayaka's time of death was around 1:30 a.m. In other words, at nighttime. And the water in the bathroom shuts off at nighttime, right?
Oh, I didn't know that. Actually, I haven't taken a shower yet.
Oh my.
You're no different! You smell like a big, fat, ugly donkey!
Hmm? I'm not sure whether to take that as an insult or a compliment.
An insult, obviously.
So anyway, if Sayaka never touched the sword, then that means the killer is the only one who used the sword. But hold on. If that's right, then the one who damaged the sheath with the kitchen knife was...
I got it! Sayaka? She had the kitchen knife?
But we already said that the attack started with...
The person with the knife attacked first, and the sword was used as an impromptu defense.
Then the one who attacked first was...
Sayaka?
Now do you understand? She wasn't a blameless victim in this.
No, far from it. It's almost as if... she'd been planning to commit a murder of her own. She took the knife from the kitchen, then invited the culprit to the room she was staying in. And if it's true that she had the kitchen knife and attacked without provocation...
Indeed. These are all the actions of an assailant.
Which brings up another point. Makoto, Sayaka was the one who suggested you two switch rooms. Correct? Maybe the reason she wanted to switch rooms... was so that she could pin the crime on you. That is a possibility, is it not?
Sayaka wanted to... on me?
That would also explain why she would switch the nameplates. She wanted to get whoever she had targeted to come to Makoto's room where she was staying. And by committing the murder there, instead of her room, that would implicate Makoto. But for that to work, the target had to be lured out while still keeping the room swap a secret. If the target knew she had switched rooms, they would have become suspicious right away.
So all that's why she switched the names?
But doesn't that plan seem a little risky? For one thing, even if her plan worked, Mr. Naegi would just tell everyone they'd switched rooms.
I don't know. I'm not sure our soft-hearted Makoto is capable of that kind of cutthroat behavior. I'm sure Sayaka realized the same thing, which is why, out of all of us, she asked him to switch rooms.
Plus, she was the ultimate pop sensation. A totally forgettable kid, or a national superstar. Who are you more likely to believe?
Wait, then... you're saying she had this all planned out?
Holy shit!
But in the end, her plan backfired. She launched her attack with the knife, then found herself under attack in turn. That must be when her wrist got broken, and she was forced to drop the knife.
The tables were suddenly turned on her, and she died at the hands of the one she'd planned to murder.
Just hold on! That can't be true! Because...
Hey! Hey! You guys have totally derailed the argument! You're being super boring right now! Come on, hurry up and decide who did it! Wouldn't it be awful if I had to punish you all just because you ran out of time?
Oh yeah, we gotta decide who we think did it.
Makoto. Right now, you just need to concentrate on figuring out the answer to this mystery. If we can't uncover who murdered Sayaka, it's over for all of us.
It's easy just to say, hey, decide who did it. But there just aren't any more clues, right? No, it's wrong! There still might be one clue left. Sayaka's dying message.
Dying? Wait, what did you say?
The dying message. She wrote something on the wall behind her, remember? 11037, written in her own blood. There must be a clue about the killer hidden in there.
Well, before we get too far into that, I need to ask, can we really be sure that Sayaka is the one who wrote it?
I got it! Her left index finger had blood on it. That could only be because she used that finger to write the message.
I see. She broke her right wrist during the fight, so she'd have to use her left hand to write.
Sure. I think we can all agree Sayaka wrote it. But still, what the heck do those numbers mean? 11037?
Hey, Chihiro. You're a computer nerd or whatever, right? You should know all about numbers and shit.
No, that's not... Yes, I'm a programmer, but I don't see any kind of meaning in these numbers.
Of course. It's because they're not numbers.
Oh! Yeah, it looks like...
Huh? What? What?
No, it's just...
I'll look at the numbers, assuming they're not numbers. Don't these first two, 1-1, look less like two numbers and more like one letter?
Ah, you're right. The connecting line is barely there, so I assumed it was 1-1, but looking at it now, you could also read it as an N.
Whoa, you might have finally just said something worth a shit.
My little gray cells are really getting excited now.
But even if that really is an N, N037 doesn't make any more sense than before.
Rotate the image 180 degrees.
Oh my god! Now I see! She wrote down the killer's name!
Huh? You just shot past the clue part and right on to who did it! So, whose name did she write?
Here's my answer! The key to solving this mystery was simply to rotate the writing 180 degrees. If you turn the message around, it becomes the letters L-E-O-N. L-E-O-N. Or more accurately, Leon.
What? What the hell are you talking about? It's just a coincidence. Just a bunch of random squiggles that happen to look like my name.
No, it's not random at all. She wrote that message on the wall behind her as she was leaning up against it. In that position, she couldn't move to write normally, and had to write upside down, as it were. And as a result, when you look at it standing in front of her, it ends up getting flipped. Try it for yourself if you want. Write something sitting like her, and the letters will be inverted.
That sounds like one hell of a stretch to me. I'm the killer? You can't just go and say shit like that.
If you're not the killer, then why did you try to destroy the evidence?
Huh?
You know what I'm talking about, right, Makoto? The evidence Leon tried to get rid of?
I got it! You mean the burnt shirt piece I found laying on the ground by the incinerator, right?
As the killer stabbed Sayaka, they must have gotten some of her blood on them. And to dispose of the shirt covered in the victim's blood, they threw it into the incinerator.
But one piece burned off and got left behind.
And the killer didn't notice. If they had, they most certainly would have panicked. Isn't that right, Leon?
But is one scrap of fabric enough to conclude that Leon is guilty?
Yeah, I mean, Leon's not the only one wearing a white button-up.
That's right! There are plenty of other people here with shirts like mine. But just that one little charred piece, there's no way you can say for sure who it belongs to.
You're right. That alone isn't enough. But there are some other points that may reveal the truth.
Are you finally starting to understand? The answers to all the riddles are right here.
Yeah, I think so. you look closely at how the shirt was disposed of, we should be able to figure out who the killer is.
Oh yeah, that's a good point. I think I know what you're gonna say. You can't reach the incinerator without opening the gate in front of the trash room, right? And obviously, you wouldn't be able to hit the switch to turn it on, either. You'd need the key to get in, and the one with the key was the person on cleaning duty. So the killer had to be whoever was in charge of taking care of the trash, right?
Interesting.
Trash room.
Whoever was on cleaning duty must have had it, right?
So the only one who could get to the incinerator was the person in charge of the trash?
And you'd have to get close to the incinerator in order to just...
No, that's wrong!
Hold on. I think I know how someone could dispose of the evidence without using the trash room key.
But if you can't get past the gate, you couldn't possibly turn on the incinerator, could you?
Yes, you could, if you used this.
What is it, some kind of glass ball? It's busted to hell.
Actually, it was supposed to be a crystal ball, but...
But how would you use it?
I got it! The killer simply took aim at the incinerator switch and threw the ball through a gap in the gate. All they had to do was hit that switch, and the incinerator would come to life.
Someone threw that through a gap in the gate?
Remember what you said before, Hifumi?
Had the key, so the only way the incinerator could have been turned on without his knowledge was because the killer was able to hit the switch without opening the gate. Once they'd gotten the incinerator going, all they had to do was ball up the shirt and toss it in.
Hey, come on! What the hell is this?
All you have to do is look at the scene to know that the killer never actually went inside the trash room. The shards of broken glass, the incinerator left running, the piece of shirt that escaped the fire. If the killer had been on cleaning duty, the evidence would have been taken care of much more thoroughly.
Wait, no, just hold on.
But the distance from the gate to the incinerator has to be at least 30 feet, right? The pinpoint accuracy you'd need to throw a glass ball that far and hit something that small. Could someone really do that?
That's right! There's no way! It'd be impossible!
Difficult, absolutely. Impossible? I don't think so. Because the killer is...
I got it!
Because the killer is the ultimate baseball star.
Isn't that right, Leon?
Do you have any idea how stupid you sound right now?
A target 30 feet away would surely be little challenge for the ultimate baseball star.
You can't be serious. I'm not the killer! These goddamn shipper brains have got it all wrong, I'm telling you!
You still won't admit it? Okay, then. Makoto, go ahead and review the incident one more time to make his crime perfectly clear. And with that, we can end this.
Listen to me! What the hell do you mean, end this?
what you want, Leon. But all the questions have been answered, and the truth has been revealed. Now here's what happened. Here's exactly what happened. I think I'd better take one more look back at the case from the beginning. Last night, the killer went to the room Sayaka was in. In other words, my room. From what we can tell, Sayaka invited that person there intending to kill them. She attacked them with the knife she'd taken from the kitchen earlier. But then something happened that she wasn't prepared for. They grabbed the fake sword I put in my room and fought back. During the struggle, a strike from the sword broke Sayaka's right wrist. And that's when she lost her grip on the kitchen knife. finding herself cornered, Sayaka panicked and ran into the bathroom. The killer went after her, but couldn't get the bathroom door open. What they didn't know was that my bathroom door got stuck easily, and there was a trick to opening it. Sayaka knew about that because I told her, but of course the killer had no way of knowing. So instead, the killer forced the door open, took the kitchen knife, and stabbed Sayaka. But with what strength she had remaining, Sayaka left a dying message. To keep the killer from noticing, she wrote it on the wall behind her. And with that, all her strength was gone. With Sayaka dead, the killer quickly began destroying the evidence. First, they took off their shirt, which was covered in their victim's blood. Then they took the lint roller in my room and cleaned up the entire area. They wanted to make sure they got rid of any trace they'd ever been there. Afterwards, the killer headed to the trash room to destroy their bloody shirt. They tried to burn the shirt using the incinerator there, but the trash room was blocked off by an especially sturdy gate, preventing access to the incinerator. So they came up with a plan to use Hiro's crystal ball, which he'd left in the laundry room. The killer managed to throw the ball through the gap in the gate and hit the incinerator switch. For any normal person, that'd be an impossible throw, but the killer had the confidence to take a shot. And that's because the killer was the ultimate baseball star. The crystal ball, thrown with absolute precision, hit the switch on the incinerator, which then quickly roared to life. Having destroyed the final piece of evidence, they left the area with, I imagine, a sigh of relief. But there was one thing they missed. Part of the shirt they'd thrown into the fire burnt away and fell out of the incinerator. The killer didn't notice this, and so left behind a piece of indisputable evidence. Isn't that right, Leon? It would appear that Hiro simply forgot his crystal ball in the laundry room. You went there to try and wash the blood out of your shirt, and that's where you saw it, right? Seeing the ball, you thought of a way to take care of everything.
So, Leon, do you object to anything that's been said?
Do I object? Hell yes, I object! Of course I do! I object, I object, I object! I mean, all of this is just a bunch of stupid theories! You need evidence! Where's the evidence? Without evidence, it's all bullshit! It's bullshit and I refuse to acknowledge it!
Well then, I guess this is as good a time as any to present the evidence that proves you did it. Makoto, I believe you're in possession of that evidence.
When the killer removed the screws from the doorknob, they didn't use anything from your room to do it. Instead, they must have used something that belonged to them.
I refuse to acknowledge you! You're stupid! Stupid, stupid, stupid! Stupid, 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 stupid! Where's your proof? You kidding me? Not a chance! It wasn't me! Stupid! You lied! Stop talking! Shut up! Where's your proof? You kidding me? Not a chance! You lied! Shut up! Where's your proof? You kidding me? Not a chance! It wasn't me! Stupid!
When the killer removed the screws from the doorknob, they didn't use anything from your room to do it. Instead, they must have used something that belonged to them.
I refuse to acknowledge you! Stupid, stupid, stupid! Where's your proof? You kidding me? Not a chance! It wasn't me! Stupid! You lied! Stop talking! Shut up! Where's your proof? You kidding me? Not a chance! You lied! Shut up! Where's your proof? You kidding me? Not a chance! It wasn't me! Where's your proof?
This should prove it. The screws on the bathroom doorknob were removed. I wonder what kind of tool the killer used to remove that.
I mean, it had to be a screwdriver, right?
Oh, yeah. I'm pretty sure the toolkits we got each have one inside.
And that must be what he used. There aren't any other tools anywhere.
But the toolkit in my room had clearly never been used.
That's because the culprit didn't know it was your room. They thought they were in Sayaka's room.
Only the boys got toolkits, so the killer naturally assumed there wouldn't be one in there.
Okay, then whose toolkit did the killer use?
Stupid, stupid, stupid!
It had to be their very own toolkit.
Stupid, 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 stupid!
Leon, would you mind showing us your toolkit? If I'm right about this, then the screwdriver will show some evidence of being used.
Stupid! Huh?
And if you say you used it for something else, you'll have to explain exactly when, where, and why.
And let me say this right now. I lost it isn't an excuse at this point.
Stupid.
So, you have no rebuttal?
Then it would seem we are finished here.
Looks like you've reached your verdict. Then are we ready to cast our votes? You all have a lever in front of you. Use it to make your selection. Oh, just to remind you all, make triple sure you vote for someone. You wouldn't want to be punished for something so minor, right? Okay, then let's get excited! Who will be chosen as the Blackened? Will you make the right choice? Or the dreadfully wrong one? What's it gonna be? What's it gonna be?
Have a choice. So that's why.
None of you are any different!
I was just.
Hey! Come on!
That's enough. Calm down.
Ba-bum, ba-bum. Yes, indeed!
Punishment? You mean execution?
Wait a second!
Yeah, that's it.
Is that okay? Do you understand?
So, that's why...
Oh!
Huh?
kills!
I'm begging you! Please, don't do this!
Hey, come on now!
Stop! Please!
Now then, I've prepared a very special punishment!
No, 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 no!
Let's give it everything we've got! It's punishment time!
No!
Extreme!
I can't take it.
Well?
Damn you!
What the heck? Say what?
Well...
Hey,
Shit.
Just a second. Makoto. Listen. It's true. However, so... Certainly. Anyway... Right. Correct. Hey. What?
Thank you.